The Quran is not the accounts of Muhammad, peace be upon him, or his companions. It is the words of God directly revealed, right?
But if you look at the Bible, for example, the genealogy of Jesus, are you familiar with it?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, excellent. So, and Jacob begotten Joseph, the husband of Mary, to whom was born Jesus, who was called Christ, right? I'm sure, you know. So, if you take it all the way back up, Isaac, Abraham, David, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. If you look at the same genealogy in Luke, you will find then Joseph was the son of Heli. So you see the...
But the difference being...
Excellent.
I mean, what the difference is there is the fact that... I would have to pull out my materials to be able to quote it exactly, but
I mean, you're obviously well versed in the Bible.
One of them had married, and the husband died.
Whose husband died?
The
question is, whose son is Joseph? Is he? It says clearly the son of Heli here, right?
Mm-hmm, right.
And so, it says clearly that he was begotten, or. Genealogy 1. There you go. Jacob. So is Jacob and Heli are not the same, right?
No.
Okay, so there's two different accounts.
But
even
no,
if you take
no,
it back to
no,
King David, the number of generations is different, right? I'm sure you've studied this already.
Different than what?
Then the account in Matthew and Luke don't match, right?
Well, the reason is because some of them would, with the Hebrews, and okay, this person dies, like a couple is married, okay?
Okay.
And the husband dies.
Okay.
Okay. Is the responsibility of his brother to marry?
Okay.
His wife.
Whose brother married whose wife? This is Jesus' genealogy from Joseph.
We're talking about. Yes, we're talking about the
So Joseph, the who was Joseph's father? Let's just ask that question.
I don't remember who Joseph's father is.
So
but I know.
Okay.
I've
I don't want to put you on the spot. Go home.
I know, but
take
I've read
it,
this
take,
before.
Look it up. Come back to
I
us.
No, I have. I've read it
okay,
before.
How did Judas die?
Judas hung himself.
Hung himself? Okay.
And we believe that he hung himself and the rope fell and his guts were cast upon on the ground.
Okay, so let's look at Acts, right? Now this man, he purchased a field with the wages of iniquity. So the money he got, what did he do with it?
Mm-hmm. I don't remember what he did with it.
Oh, it's right here.
Mm-hmm.
Acts 1:18. Now this man, Judas.
Oh, purchased the field. That's
so what did he do? He bought a field, right?
Right.
So if you look at the same account, in Matthew, he threw the money away. Then he threw down the pieces of silver in the temple. So did he buy land or did he throw it away?
I don't know.
Yeah. So see
what I'm saying is there's just as many of these in the Quran.
None. Here you go. Find one and I'll leave Islam right in front of you.
I've read it.
Find me one.
Well,
just single one. So the earliest New Testament manuscripts are in what language?
Greek.
Koine Greek, right?
Mm-hmm.
And what was the language that was spoken by Jesus and the disciples?
Aramaic.
Excellent. So if you look at even the earliest manuscripts you have, there are 70 to 100, depending on how small the credit card size and so on, then you're going to look at hundreds of years after the time of Jesus. Who narrated to who? There's no information. Who the actual scribes were, we don't know. We do know that Matthew didn't write the Gospel of Matthew. It's according to Matthew. We know Mark didn't write it. Luke, MacArthur, and any study Bible you get, none of them say that they were the actual authors, right? So the actual authors are all anonymous. You can look this up. That's no problem, right? So you are basing your belief on a book written by anonymous authors that were not present at the time of Jesus, peace and blessings be upon him, that clearly has copyist errors at minimum, maybe more than that.